All those cowboys riding around and fooling with those ropes. I don't care about all that. I'm sick of them. I don't see why they don't have more of those romantic comedies. I like those sweet little love stories. They are nice and wholesome. Mrs. Swell was saying to me only yesterday, "Mrs. Zero," she said. What I like is one of those wholesome stories with just a sweet, simple love story. You are right, Mrs. Tubelf, I said. That's what I like too. They are showing too many westerns at the theater. I'm getting sick of them. We should go to a different theater. There is a comedy called Some Like It Up. Mrs. Tubelf was telling me about it. She says it's a supreme. She says she laughed so hard she nearly passed out. And they have another feature with our gardener on the beach. She's sweet, but I don't like her clothes. Mrs. Nine was telling me that Marilyn Monroe wasn't living with her husband. He's her second too. I don't know whether they are divorced or just separated. You wouldn't think it to see her on the screen. She looks so sweet and innocent. Maybe it's not true. You can't believe all you read. Mrs. Seven was telling me that her brother-in-law has a friend that used to go to school with her. He says her name is not Marilyn Monroe. Her real name is Norma Jean Baker. But Mrs. Twelve says, don't miss some like it up. Mrs. Eight was telling me this playing at the Roosevelt Wednesday night. So don't tell me you want to go to the other theater. The Eight have seen it downtown, but we never go downtown, do we? You wouldn't go downtown if wild horses drag you. You wait until they come uptown. Well, I don't want to wait. I want to see them when everybody else has seen them and another month later. Now don't go telling me you don't have the money. You could dig up the money all right if you wanted. I noticed you always have the money to go to the ball game. But when it comes to me having a good time, then it is always, I haven't got the money. I have to start saving. A bad luck you will ever say. I can barely make ends meet. And you are talking about saving. And don't go pulling that stuff about being tired. I've been working hard all day. Twice a day in the subway is enough for me. Tired? Where do you get that tired stuff anyhow? What about me? Where do I come in? Scrubbing floors, cooking your meals, and washing your dirty clothes. And you? Sitting on a chair all day, just adding up numbers and waiting for 5:30. There is no 5:30 for me. I don't wait for no whistle. I don't get any vacations either. And what's more, I don't get a paycheck every Saturday night either. I'd like to know where you live without me. And what have I got to show for it? Slaving my life away to give you a home? What's in it for me, I'd like to know? But it's my own fault, I guess. I was a fool for marrying you. I wish I could do it all over again. You were going to do wonders, you were. You weren't going to be able to keep her long. Oh no, not you. Wait till you got started. You were going to show them. There wasn't any job in the bookstore that was too big for you. Well, I've been waiting. Waiting for you to get started. Has been a good long wait too. 25 years. 25 years tomorrow and I haven't seen anything change. You must be proud, aren't you? 25 years in the same job and never missed a day. That's something to be proud of, isn't it? What about being a store manager? I guess you forgot about that, didn't you? And me, at home, here looking at the same four walls, working my fingers to the bone to make ends meet. 7 years since you got a raise. And if you don't get one tomorrow, I bet you won't have the guts to go and ask for one. I didn't pick much when I picked you. But not much to be proud of. She isn't walking around tonight. You can bet your sweet life on that. And she won't be walking around any more nights either. Not in this house anyhow. Oh, Judy Abor, poor! The idea of her coming to live in a house with respectable people. They should have given her 6 years, not 6 months. If I was the judge, I would have given her life. A bitch like that. I guess you are sorry she's gone. I guess you would like to sit home every night and watch her. There's something to be proud of, you are. You had better not start anything with women if you know what's good for you. I put up with a lot, but I won't put up with that. I've been slaving away for 25 years, making a home for you and nothing to show for it. If you were any kind of a man, you would have a decent job by now, and I would be getting some comfort out of that, instead of being just a slave washing pots and pans. I have stood it for 25 years, and I guess I will have to spend it 25 more. But don't you go starting nothing, you gentlemen.
$0.42, $1.50, $1.50, $1.25, $2, $0.39, $27.50.
Oh, speed up a little, can't you?
What's the rush? Tomorrow's another day.
You make me sick.
You make me sicker.
Oh, go on, you're losing time.
But then quit being so bossy. $3, $2.69, $81.50, $40, $8.75. Who do you think you are anyhow?
Oh, never mind who I think I am. You tend to your work.
Don't give me so many orders. 60 cents, 24 cents, 75 cents, $1.50, $2.50, $1.50, $1.50, $2.50. I don't have to take it from you. And what's more, I won't.
Just quit talking.
I'll talk all I want. $3, 50 cents, $2.50, $3.50, 50 cents, $1.50, 50 cents.
You make me sick. Always complaining about something. Talk, 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 just like all the other women do. Women make me sick.
Who do you think you're in now, bossing me around? I don't have to take it from you. And once more, I won't.
Women make me sick. They're all alike. The judge gave her 6 months. I wonder what they do in prison. Peel potatoes? I bet she's sore at me. Maybe she'll even try to kill me when she gets out. You can't tell what a woman's liable to do. I better be careful.
I'm getting sick of this. Always complaining about something. Never a decent word out of you. Not even the time of day.
I guess she won't have the nerve at that. Maybe she doesn't even know it's me. They didn't put my name in the paper. Bastards. And maybe she's been in prison before. A bitch like that. But she didn't have nothing on that night. Nothing but a shirt.
Isn't that whistle ever going to blow? You didn't used to be like that before. Not even good morning, good evening. I haven't done anything to you. It's the young girls going around without bras.
You make me sick. I'm sick of looking at your face. Your face is getting all yellow. Why don't you put some makeup on? She was putting on makeup that one time. On her cheeks and on her lips. And that blue stuff in her eyes. Just sitting there in a shimmy and putting on makeup and walking around the room with her legs all bare.
I wish I was dead.
I was a goddamn fool to let Dubai get onto me. She would still be living there if Dubai hadn't got onto me. Damn her!
I wish I was dead.
Well, maybe another one will move in. Man, that would be great. But the wife's got her eyes on me now.
I'm scared to do it, though.
Hey, you should move into that room. It's cheaper than where you're living now. Well, I better tell you, I don't want these men to be picking on you.
Gas. The smell of it makes me sick. What did you say?
Oh, I didn't say anything.
I thought you did.
Well, you thought wrong.
$1.60, $1.50, $2.90, $1.62.
Why the hell should I tell you? A fat chance of you forgetting to pull down the shade?
test for carbolic. They might get out to me.
I wonder where she'll go when she gets out. Boy, I would love to make a date with her. Why didn't I go over there tonight, the wife went to Brooklyn? She would have never found out.
I wish I knew what to ask for.
I guess I didn't have the nerve.
I've seen Pauline frantic boot once. Where could I get a pistol, though?
Nerve? I got as much nerve as anybody. I'm a married man, and I'm on the level.
I'll bet you'll be sore then that you've been so mean to me.
The time the wife had pneumonia, I thought she was going to die. But she didn't. And the doctor's bill was $87. Well, hey, wait a minute. Did you just say $87?
What?
Was the last you said $87?
$42.50.
Well, I made a mistake. Hold on. All right, shoot.
$6, $3.15, $2.25, $0.65, $1.20. You talk to me as if I was dirt.
I wonder if I could kill the wife without anybody finding out. In bed some night, with a pillow maybe.
I used to think you were stuck on me.
I'd get caught though. They always have ways.
You used to be so nice and friendly when I first came here. You used to talk to me then.
Maybe she'll die soon. I realized she was coughing this morning.
You used to tell me all kinds of things. You were gonna show them all. Just the same, you're still sitting there.
Then I can do whatever I damn please. Oh boy.
Maybe it isn't all your fault. Maybe if you had the right kind of a wife. Somebody with a lot of common sense. Somebody refined. Me.
But at that I guess I'd get tired of bumming around while a fella needs some place to hang his hat.
I wish she would die.
And when you start going with women, you're liable to get into trouble. And even lose your job, maybe.
Maybe you'd marry me.
God, I wish I'd gone over there that night.
Then I could quit working.
Lots of women will be glad to get me.
You could look a long time before you find a sensible, refined girl like me.
They could look a long time before they find a steady meal to cook like me.
I guess I'll be too old to have kids. They say it isn't safe after 35.
Maybe I'd marry you. You'd be all right at that.
I wonder if you don't want any kids. Whether there's any way.
Well, hey, slow down a minute. What do you think I am, a machine?
What do you want anyhow? First you say it's too slow, then you say it's too fast. I guess you don't know what you want.
Well, you never mind about that. Just slow down.
I'm getting sick of this. I'm going to ask to be transferred.
Yeah, go ahead. You can't make me mad.
Keep quiet. $2.45, $1.20, $1.50, 90 cents, 63 cents.
Marry you? I guess not. You'd be as bad as the one that I got.
You wouldn't care if I did ask. I've got a good mind to ask.
I was a fool to get married.
Then I'd never see you at all.
What chance has a guy with a woman tied around his neck?
That time at the store picnic? The year your wife couldn't come. You were nice to me then.
25 years, holding down the same job.
We were together all day, just sitting around under the trees.
I wonder if the boss even remembers it being 25 years.
And coming home that night, we sat together in the big delivery wagon.
Well, I got a hunch that there's a big race coming to me.
I wonder what it feels like to be really kissed. Men, dirty pigs. They want the easy ones.
If he doesn't come to me, I'll go right to him.
I wish I was dead. You could have kissed me if you wanted to.
Boss, I'll say. I'm not quite satisfied. I've been holding down the same job for 25 years. And if I'm staying, I gotta see a future ahead of me. Zero, he'll say, I'm glad you came in. I have my eye on you, Zero. Nothing gets by me. I know that, boss, I'll say. You're a valuable man, Zero, he'll say. And I want you to be right up here with me in the front office. You're done adding figures. Monday morning, you move up here.
Those kisses in the movies. Those long ones. Right on the mouth.
Then I'll start going right after that. Wait till I get started.
That one the other night, the devil's alibi, he put his arms around her and her head fell back like she was in a daze.
Just give me about 2 years and I'll show those guys where they get off.
I guess that's what it's like, a kind of a daze. When I see them like that, I just seem to forget everything.
Then, a place for me in Manhattan, maybe a Cadillac. Wait till I get started, I'll show them.
When I see them like that, I just seem to forget everything. I can see it now and I kind of have closed my eyes. The way her head fell back and he put his mouth right against hers. Oh God, must be great.
The whistle. Good night, Mr. Ward.
Oh, mister!
Yes, sir? Do you want me, sir?
Yes, just come here for a moment, will you?
Yes, sir, right away.
Mr. Zero, I've been wanting to have a little talk with you.
Yes, sir. I've been kind of expecting that.
Oh, you have, had you?
Yes, sir.
How long have you been working here, Mr.
Zero.
Yes, Mr. Zero.
25 years.
25 years? That's a long time.
Yes, sir. I've never missed a day.
And you've been doing the same work all that time?
Yes, sir. Right here at this desk.
Well, in that case, you probably wouldn't mind a change, would you?
No, sir, I won't. That's the truth.
Mr. Zero, we've been planning a change in this department for quite some time.
I always thought you had your eye on me, sir.
You were right. The fact is, my efficiency experts have recommended the installation of adding machines.
The adding machines?
Yes, you've probably seen them. A mechanical device that adds automatically.
Yeah. With the keys and handle that you pull, right?
That's it. It does the work in half the time, and a high school girl can operate it. But of course, I'm sorry to lose an old and faithful employee.
Excuse me, but Sidney, would you mind saying that again, sir?
I said I'm sorry to lose an old employee who's been with me for so many years. But in an organization like this, efficiency must be the first consideration. You will draw your salary for the full month, and I will have my secretary to give you a letter of recommendation.
Doesn't get very cold in an hour. And of course, the part about our having company tonight. Doesn't matter. Don't even have sense enough to come home on time. Didn't I tell you we are going to have a lot of company tonight? Didn't you know the ones are coming? And the twos, and the threes, and the fours, and the fives. Didn't I tell you to be home on time? I might as well talk to a stone mob. I guess you had some important business to attend to, like watching the scoreboard. You sure do have a lot of business to attend to. It is a wonder you have time enough to come home at all. Walk in, hang up your hat, and put on the nose bag. And me, in the hot kitchen all day, cooking your supper and waiting for you to get good and ready to come home. Maybe the boss kept you late tonight, telling you what a big noise you are and how the store couldn't have got along if you hadn't been pushing a pen for 25 years. Where is the old man who's been doing you? I bet he gave you a big raise, didn't he? Promoted you from the third floor to the fourth, maybe. Raise. A fat chance you're gonna getting a raise. All they gotta do is put an ad in the papers. There's 10,000 like you laying around the streets. You will be holding the same job at the end of 25 years, if you hadn't forgot how to add by that time. There's the doorbell. The company is here already and we hardly finished the supper. But I'm going to clear off the table whether you are finished or not. If you want your supper, you should come home on time, not standing around and looking at the scoreboards. Wait a minute. Don't open the door yet. Do you want the company to see all the mats? And go and put on a clean collar. You got red ink all over it. I should think after pushing a pen for 25 years, you would learn how to deal without getting ink on your collar. I guess I can stay up all night now, washing the dishes. That is what a man has got a wife for, isn't it? Doesn't he let her eat with him at the same table? All she has got to do is do the washing, cook the meals, and scrub the floors when the company goes. But believe me, you are going to sling him in the shower when the company goes tonight. There's the bell again. Open the door, will you?
How do you do? How do you do?
How do you do?
Never saw the like of it.
First in 14 years, the paper says.
You can't always go by the papers.
No, that's right too.
We are liable to forget from year to year.
Yeah, come to think, last year was pretty bad too.
And how about 2 years ago?
Still, this year's pretty bad.
Yeah.
No getting away from that.
Might be a whole lot worse.
It's all the way you look at it.
I like those little organdy dresses.
Yeah, with a little lace trimming on the sleeves.
Well, I like to play it myself.
I always say to plainer the more you find.
Well, I don't think some lace does any harm.
No, it's kind of dressed up.
Well, I always say it is all a matter of taste.
I saw you at the Rose Bath movie Thursday night, Mr. One.
Awful show, I say.
They are getting worse all the time.
But who was the charming waiter, Mr. One?
Now, don't you go making trouble for me. That was my sister.
That's what they all say.
Never mind, I'll bet Mrs. One knows what is what.
Well, he can do what he likes, as long as he behaves himself.
You are a lucky guy, Juan. Had chance I got getting away from the wife, even with my sister.
You ought to be glad you got a good wife to look after you.
That's right, Mrs. Tree.
I guess I know where's the pants in your house, Tree.
Never mind. I saw them holding hands at the movie the other night.
She must have been trying to get some money away from me.
Swell chance anybody would have of getting any money away from you.
They sure were coming, couple.
Well, I think we ought to change the subject.
Yes, let's change the subject.
Did you hear the one about the traveling salesman?
Yeah, it seems this guy was a sleeper.
Going from Albany to San Diego.
And in the next door was an old maid with a wooden leg.
Well, I learned about it in 19...
Did you hear about the Sixers?
They're getting a divorce.
It's the second time for it.
They are two of a kind, if you ask me.
One's as bad as the other.
Worse. They say that she was right too.
I think this woman's rights business is bullshit.
It sure is. Politics is man's business.
Yeah, a woman's place isn't the home.
That's right. Looking after the kids instead of hanging around the streets.
You hit the nail on the head that time.
The trouble is they don't know what they want.
Men sure get retired.
They sure lazy a lot.
And dirty.
Always grumbling about something when they're not lying
or messing up the house.
Well, I tell my man he gets off.
Business conditions are sure bad.
Never been worse.
I don't know what we are coming to.
I look for a big cinema shop in about 3 months.
Wouldn't surprise me a bit.
We are sure heading for trouble.
My aunt has gallstones.
My mother has a tumor.
My sister is in menopause.
My cousin Sultan has syphilis.
My niece has rabies.
My boy has swine flu.
I never felt better in my life, knock on wood.
So much agitation, that's at the bottom of it.
That's it. Two damn many strikes.
Foreign agitators. That's what it is.
They ought to be run out the country.
What the hell do they want anyhow?
They don't know what they want if you ask me.
America for Americans, that's what I say.
That's right.
Damn foreigners.
Damn niggers.
Damn kites.
Damn cooks.
Damn judge.
Damn packets.
Dirty Arabs.
Deport them.
Jail them.
Shoot them.
Bomb them. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Why so pensive, Mr. Zero?
I'm thinking.
Well, be careful not to sprain your mind.
Look at the poor men all by themselves. We are very sociable.
It seems you are neglecting the ladies.
There is a doorbell.
I'll go. It's for me.
I'm looking for Mr. Zero. Let's talk along.
Oh, wait a minute.
Hey, what are you trying to pull?
Just want to give you something.
What's that?
It's the collar I wore.
What do I want it for?
It's got blood stains on it.
Okay, come along.
I need to go. You'll have to dry the dishes yourself.
What are they taking you for?
I killed the boss this afternoon.
I'm not saying I didn't. Sure, I killed them. Damn warriors. They give me a good stiff pain. That's what they give me. Half the time, I don't even know what the hell they're talking about. Objection sustained, objection overruled. What's the big idea anyhow? You haven't heard me do any objecting, have you? No? What's the idea of objecting? You've got a right to know. What I say is, if a guy kills another guy, you've got a right to call him for it. That's what I say. I know all about that. I've been on the jury too. Damn lawyers. All that pull about being red ink on the bill file. Red ink? It was blood. I want you to get that right. I killed him right through the heart with the bill file. I want you to get that right. All of you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 of you. 6 and 6. 6 and 6, that makes 12, 3 more 15, 5 more 20, and 8 more 28, and 8 more carry 2. Goddamn numbers, I can't forget them. 20 25 years. 8 hours a day, except Sundays. July and August, half a Saturday. 1 week's vacation with pay, and another week without pay if you want it. But who the hell wants it? Laying around the house listening to the wife complaining? Oh, and legal holidays, I nearly forgot that. Washington's birthday, New Year, Decoration Day, Election Day, Labor Day, Thanksgiving, Christmas. And if you're a Jew, you're a Yankeeper. And the other one, I forgot what they call it. Damn kikes, always getting two when the other guys get one. So, if a holiday comes on Sunday, you get one day off, so that's fair enough. But when the 4th of July comes on Saturday, why you're out of luck when you count the Saturdays being half day anyway? 25 years, and I never missed a day, and I was never more than 5 minutes late. Look at my time card if you don't believe me. 827, 828, 829, 830, 831, 832, 834, 839. Goddamn numbers, I can't forget them. Sure, I killed him. But why did he shut up? If he had only shut up, instead of talking about how sorry he was and what a good guy I was and this and that, I felt like saying to him, for Christ's sake, shut up! But I didn't have the nerve. I didn't have the nerve to say that to the boss. And when he went talking about how sorry he was standing right close to me. And there was this bill file where I could reach it. I shouldn't have killed him. I know. When I read about him and his three kids in the papers, I felt awful. Really. They had the kid's picture right next to mine. And the paper said the store would be closed for 3 days on account of the boss being dead. That had made me laugh. All those employees having me to thank for getting 3 days off. I shouldn't have killed him. I know that. But I thought he was giving me a raise on account of being there for 25 years. He never talked to me before. And when I saw him coming up to my desk, I felt like choking. I shouldn't have done that. Killing someone? That's wrong. There was this girl, Judy Allure. 6 months they get her. It was a dirty trick telling the cops on her, but what was I supposed to do? The wife wouldn't shut up about it. I had to do it. She used to walk around the room just in her underwear. Nothing else on, just her underwear. They gave her 6 months, and perhaps that's the last I'll ever see of her. Man, shoe salesmen are really lucky, looking at women's legs all day. Damn warriors, saying the same thing over and over again. I never said I didn't kill him, but that isn't the same as being a regular murderer. Do I look like a murderer? Do I? I never harmed anybody. Ask the wife, she'll tell you. Ask anybody. I never got into trouble. Well, you only count that time at the baseball game. That was just for fun. I'm a pretty steady guy. You gotta admit that. 25 years in one job and I never missed a day. 52 weeks in a year. 52 They didn't have to look for me, did they? I didn't try to run away, did I? Where was I going to run to? And I wasn't thinking about that at all. I'll tell you what I was thinking about. How I was going to tell the wife about being fired.
25 years in the same job and never missed a day. 25 years and nothing to show for it.
He fired me after 25 years. Did the lawyers tell you about that? Objection sustained, objection overruled, answer yes or no. It just gives me a headache, and I can't get those damn numbers out of my head. But he kept on talking and talking. There was this bill file where I could reach. I'm just a regular guy, like anybody else, like you guys. Suppose you were me. Maybe you would have done the same thing. That's the way you ought to look at it. Suppose you were me.
Yell it!
No, wait a minute. You don't understand. But I'm just giving another chance, and I'll tell you, I'll be what. I won't be stumbling down those damn lawyers, and I can't get those damn numbers out of my head. But just give me another chance, and I'll tell you how it was. You fired me after 25 years. I was there for 25 years, and you fired me after 25 years. 25 years.
Doesn't he know how to use a fork and knife?
We don't dare trust him with a knife. He might try to kill himself.
Oh, how interesting!
Now, friends, I have a little souvenir folder here, which I'm sure you'll all be interested in. It contains a picture of the murderer. A picture of the murderer's wife. The bloodstain. Murderer at the age of 6. And the spot where the body was. Oh. I'm now going to distribute these photos for examination. Don't be afraid to look at them. You don't have to buy them if you don't want to. It doesn't cost anything to look at them. Hey, no photos. All right now, friends, keep close together and follow me right this way. Watch your step, to the right. Oh yeah, what? Well.
you were coming again.
Well, I thought I would come again. Are you glad to see me?
Sure. Wow, you're all dolled up, aren't you?
Yeah, don't you like it?
You look classy.
I always look good in black. There's some way to this veil by the Hacettepe.
How much did all that cost you?
$64.20. I still have to buy some matching shoes and a bag.
Well, you'll be scrubbing floors in about a year if you go wasting your money like that.
Well, I gotta do it right, you know. It doesn't happen every day. I brought you something.
Yeah? What?
You gotta guess.
Come on, just give me a hint.
Something you like.
Well, it looks like something to eat.
Yeah. Have an egg.
Oh boy, that is just what I felt like eating.
Are they good?
Delicious.
They are the last ones I will ever make for you.
Uh-huh.
I'll tell you something, shall I?
Sure.
Well, all the while they were cooking, I was crying.
Yeah?
I just couldn't help it. The thought of it just made me cry.
Well, no use crying about it now.
I just couldn't help it.
Maybe this time next year? You'll be frying eggs for some other guy.
Not on your life.
You can never tell.
Not me once is enough for me.
Well, maybe you're right, but still. Maybe you just happen to meet some guy.
Well, if I do, there will be time enough to think about it. No use borrowing trouble.
So, how do you like being alone in the house?
It's alright.
You've got plenty of room in the bed now, don't you?
Oh, yeah. It is kind of lonesome though, you know, waking up in the morning and nobody around to talk to.
Yeah, it's the same with me.
Not that we ever did much talking.
No, that isn't it. It's just the idea of having somebody there in case you want to talk.
Yeah, that's it. I guess maybe I used to yell at you quite a lot, didn't I?
Well, no use talking about it now.
We were always at it, weren't we?
No more than any other married couples, I guess.
I don't know.
But I guess I gave you a reason.
I got my faults too.
None of us are perfect.
We got along all right, didn't we?
I'll say we did.
Remember those Sundays at the beach in the old days? Remember?
Yeah. Remember the time I dubbed you? Man, you were mad at me.
I didn't talk to you for a whole week.
Yeah, I remember that.
And remember the time I had pneumonia? And you brought me those roses, remember?
Yeah. And the doctor told me that you were going to die. I nearly sat down and cried.
Did you?
I sure did.
We had some good times, didn't we?
I'll say we did.
It is all over now.
All over is right. I haven't got much longer either.
Maybe if we had to do it over again, it would be different.
No use talking about it now.
If we only had another chance.
Yeah, we live and learn.
Doesn't seem right, does it?
Well, it's not right, but what can you do about it?
Isn't there something I can do for you before?
No, nothing.
Nothing at all?
Not a thing. I can't think of anything. But hey, you're taking good care of the scrapbook with all the clippings in it, aren't you?
Yeah, I got it right on the parlor table where everybody can see it.
Must be pretty full now, isn't it?
All but about 3 pages.
Well, there will be more tomorrow, so make sure you get them all, will you?
I will. I ordered the papers already.
Man, I never thought I'd have a book full of clippings all about myself. But there's something I'd like to ask you. Suppose you get sick, or run over or something. What will happen to the book?
Well, I kind of thought I would leave it to little Beatrice Elizabeth.
Who? Your sister's kid?
Yeah.
Why would you want it?
Well, it is nice to have, isn't it? And I wouldn't know who else to give it to.
Well, I don't want her to have it. That little fresh kid putting her dirty fingers all over it.
She's a fresh and she's a dirty. She's a sweet little thing.
Well, I don't want her to have it.
Who do you want to have it then?
I kind of thought I'd like Miss DeVore to have it.
Miss DeVore?
Yeah, you know, down at the store.
Why would she have it?
Well, I don't know. I thought she'd take good care of it. And anyhow, I'd like her to have it.
Oh, you would you?
Yes.
Well, she isn't going to get it, Miss DeVore. Why does she come in? I'd like to know when I got two sisters. sisters and a niece.
Well, I don't care about your sisters and your niece.
Well, I do. And Miss Dwarf is important to get it. Now put that in your pipe and smoke it.
What have you got to say about it? It's my book, isn't it?
No, it isn't. It is mine now, or it will be tomorrow. And I'm going to do what I like with it.
I should have given to her in the first place. That's what I should have done.
Should you? What about me? Am I your wife or what?
Why remind me of my troubles?
So what is Miss Tomorrow all of a sudden, is it? What has been going on? I would like to know between you and Miss Tomorrow.
Just knock it off.
Why didn't you marry Miss Tomorrow if you think so much of her?
I would have if I met her first.
If I meet you, don't be me after all I have done for you.
Now that your course is run, now that the end is in sight, you still think that some thunderbolt, some fiery bush, some celestial apparition will intervene between you and extinction. It's no use, Zero. You're done for.
Well, no, that's not right. That's not fair. I'm not getting a square deal.
They all say that, Zero. Now tell me, why aren't you getting a square deal?
That editing machine, was that a square deal?
Certainly, from any point of view, except a sentimental one. I mean, the machine is quick, never makes a mistake, it's always on time. It presents no problems of housing, sanitation, traffic congestion.
Well, it costs something to buy those machines, I'll tell you.
Yeah, you're right there. I mean, that's one advantage you have over the machine, yeah. But you know, experience has taught us that this initial cost of manufacture is nothing compared to the upkeep. Take the dinosaurs, for example. They literally ate themselves out of existence. And I held out for them till the last moment. And they were damn picturesque. But when it came to the question of nitrate supply, I had to yield. And so with you. We can't afford to maintain all this in idleness. I mean, all this delicate mechanism of eye, ear, hand, and brain, you never put to any use. No, you gotta go, Zero.
No, please, 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 just give me another chance. Please, give me another chance. Please.
What would you do if I gave you another chance?
Well, the first thing I'd go and look for a job.
Adding numbers?
Well, I'm not young enough to take up something new, you know?
Put the cuffs on him, girls, and make it quick.
What? No, please, you understand. Please, give me another chance. Please, no, I don't want to.
But he wants to live. No, he's not.
No, please. No, please don't take me.
Yeah.
okay. So, that makes 2,137 souls.
Crazy.
This place, alright, I tell you, I've been here lots of times.
No, I don't like this place.
Isn't this place as good as another? What are we afraid of? They are all dead ones here. They won't disturb us.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Hey, look! Here's a new one.
I tell you, I don't like this place.
Wait a minute, let's see what it says. Z-E-R-O. Z-E-R-O. Zero, that's the
Zero? Guy. Zero? He's the guy that killed us most, right?
Yeah, that's him. But I'm thinking something else. I went to prison because of him.
What for?
You know, same old stuff. Tenement house law. Section blah blah, the penal code. Third offense, 6 months.
And this guy was your...
He was a peeping Tom. We live in the same house at Prosperation. I used to see him looking in my window. And I guess his wife must have seen him too. Anyhow, they went and called the cops. And now, I'm out. And he is in.
Not so funny.
Wouldn't it be funny if we... You know, he can't do anything about it, can he?
Come on, let's get out of here. I don't like this place.
You're a bad sport. Why don't you want to spoil my fun?
I just want to go.
Okay, come on if you're afraid. You nervous man. I don't really like you.
That's funny. I thought I heard her talking and laughing. But I can't see anybody. I guess I must have been dreaming. But how could I be dreaming when I'm not asleep? Well, no one's going back. I can't go back to sleep anyhow. I might walk around a little.
Ow! Boy, I'm stiff.
It's quite lonesome here. I should have stayed where I was, but I really It's all right.
There's nothing to be afraid of. I hope I didn't frighten you.
No, you didn't. But, you know, I wasn't expected to see anybody.
You're a newcomer, aren't you?
Yeah, it's my first night here. And I can't seem to get sleep.
I can't sleep either. Hey, suppose we keep each other company, shall we?
Sure.
Then let's get ourselves comfortable. You must mind this stiffness. It wears off in a few days. If you have a camel?
Oh, no, I don't.
Well, I find it helps keep the mosquitoes away. Do you mind if I smoke?
Oh, no, I prefer you didn't.
Yeah, of course. I didn't catch your name. Mister, I say I didn't catch your name.
Well, I heard you the first time, but I'm scared if I tell you who I am and what I've done, you'd leave.
No matter what your sins may be, there's no compared to mine.
Well, I'm zero. I'm a murderer.
I remember reading about you, Mr. Zero.
And you still think you're worse than me?
1,000 times worse, Mr. Zero. 1,000,000 times worse.
Well, what did you do?
Me? I tell my murder.
Oh, go on, you're kidding me.
No? Every word I speak is the truth, Mr. Zero. I'm the foulest, the most sinful of murderers. You only murdered your employer, Mr. Zero, but I murdered my mother.
What?
Yes. My mother. My beloved mother.
Well, I've never heard of a guy killing his mother before. Why did you do it for?
Because I have a sinful heart. There's no other reason.
So, you mean to say she didn't treat you all square and all like that?
She was a saint. A saint, I tell you. So she cared for me and watched over me as only a mother can.
So you guys didn't have a fight or anything?
No. Never a harsh or an unkind word. Nothing except loving care and good advice. From my infancy, she devoted herself to guiding me on the right path. She taught me to be thrifty, to be devout, to be unselfish, to shun evil companions, and to shut my ears to all the temptations of the flesh. In short, to become a virtuous, respectable, and God-fearing man. It was a hopeless task. At 14, I began to show evidence of my sinful nature.
You didn't kill anybody else, did you?
No, thank God. There's only one murder on my soul. But I ran away from home.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. A friend of mine lent me a profane book. The only profane book I have ever read, I'm thankful to say. It was called Treasure Island. Have you ever read it?
No, I was never much on reading books.
It was a wicked book, a lurid tale of adventure. But it kindled in my sinful heart a desire to go to sea, so I ran away from home.
So what did you do? Get a job as a sailor?
I never saw the sea, not to the day of my death. Luckily, my mother's loving intuition had warned her of my intention, and I was sent back home. She welcomed me with open arms, not an angry word, not a look of reproach. But I could read the mute suffering in her eyes as we prayed together all through the night.
Man, that must have been tough. Ah, mosquitoes are really bad.
Well, I thought that experience had cured me of evil, and I began to think about a career. I wanted to go in foreign missions at first, but you see, we couldn't bear the thought of the separation. So we finally decided that I should become a profiteer.
Oh, go ahead, I'm listening.
By the time I was 20, I had a good job reading proof for a firm that printed catalogs. After a year, they promoted me and let me specialize in furniture catalogs.
Oh, that must have been a good job.
It was a very good job. I was on the furniture catalogs for 12 years. I've been on them yet.
I wish I had somebody to keep those mosquitoes away.
We were so happy together. I had my steady job, and Sundays we would go to morning, afternoon, and evening service. It was an honest and moral mode of life.
Well, it sure was.
Then came that fatal Sunday. Dr. Emmerich, our minister, was having dinner with us. He's one of the few pure spirits on earth. When he finished saying grace, we had our soup. Everything was going along as usual. We were eating our soup and discussing the sermon, just like every other Sunday I could remember. Then came the Lego land. I can see the whole scene from me. So plainly, it never leaves me. Dr. Emmerich at my right. My mother at my left. The Lego lamp on the table in front of me. And the cuckoo clock on the little shelf between the windows.
Yeah, what happened?
Well, as I started to carve the Lego... Did you ever carve a Lego lamp?
No. Well, I prefer corned beef.
It is very difficult to account for the bone. And when there's gravy in the dish, there's danger of spilling it. Some mother always used to hold the dish for me. She leaned forward, just as she always did, and I could see the gold bucket around her neck. It had my picture in it. And one of my baby curls. Well, I raised my knife to carve the Lego lamb, but instead I cut my mother's throat!
Man, you must have been crazy.
Crazy? Don't try to justify me, I was not crazy. They tried to prove at the trial that I was crazy, but Dr. Emmerich was there. He saw it all. He saw it from the first. He knew that it was my sinful nature. And he told me what was in store for me.
Well, your troubles are over now.
Over? Do you think this is the end?
Sure. What more can they do to us?
Do you think there can ever be any peace for people like us? Murders. Sinners. Don't you know what awaits us? Flames. Eternal flames.
Don't keep your shirt on, buddy. They are not going to do that to us.
There's no escape. No escape, I tell you. We're doomed. We're doomed to suffer unspeakable torment through all eternity. It won't be long now. We receive our son soon. How did you, Mr. Zero? I'm very, very glad to see you again.
Same here. Well, I wasn't expected to see either.
Yeah.
Sure, it's a nice place. I wouldn't mind resting here a while.
You may if you like.
I tell the world my feet are sore. I haven't walked so much in years.
Well, sit down here, under the tree.
Do they let you sit on grass?
Yes.
I wonder, would it be alright if I took my shoes off? My feet are really tired.
Yeah, go on. There are people here who go barefoot.
Yeah? Oh, they sure must be nuts. Well, the grass feels nice and cool. Sure is a nice place. What do they call this place anyhow?
The Elysian Fields.
The which?
The Elysian Fields.
Oh. Well, still, it's a nice place.
Yeah. They say this is the most desirable of all places. Only the most favorite do remain here.
Really? Well, that lets me out then. But what are you doing here? I thought you'd be burned by now.
Mr. Zero, I'm the most unhappy of men.
Why? Because you're not being roasted alive?
Nothing is turning out as I expected. I saw everything. The flames, the tortures, an eternity of suffering as the just punishment for my unspeakable crime. But it has all turned out so differently.
That's pretty soft for you, isn't it?
No! It is right and just that I should be punished. I could have endured it stoically. All through those endless ages of indescribable torment, I should have exulted in the magnificence of divine justice. But this is maddening. What becomes of justice? What becomes of morality? What becomes of right and wrong? It's maddening, simply maddening. Oh, if only Dr. Emmerich was here to advise me.
So, you mean to say they didn't call you for killing your mother?
No, it's terrible.
What did I tell you?
Only I was to come here and remain until I understood.
What? I don't get it. What do they want you to understand?
I don't know, Mr. Zero. I don't know. If only I had anything of what they meant. Listen quietly for a moment. Do you hear anything?
No.
You don't hear any music, do you?
Music? No, I don't hear anything.
Well, people here say that the music never stops.
Oh, they are kidding you.
Do you think so?
Sure thing. There's no sound.
Perhaps they are capable of anything. But I haven't told you the bitterest of my disappointments.
Well, spill it. I'm getting used to hearing bad news anyway.
Yeah. When I first came to this place, my first thought was to find my dear mother. I wanted to ask for her forgiveness, and I wanted her to help me understand.
And she couldn't do it?
She is not here, Mr. Zero. Here, where only the most favored dwell. That wisest and purest of all spirits is nowhere to be found. I don't understand it.
Mr. Zero!
If you were to see some of the people here, the things they do.
Oh, wait a minute, will you? I think somebody's calling me.
Mr. Zero, hey!
Who the hell is that now? I wonder if the wife's on my trail already. That would be great, wouldn't it? And I figured on her being good for another 20 years anyhow.
Mr. Zero, hey!
Well, that's not her voice. Well, there she comes, wherever she is.
What do you know about that?
I thought I never kept up to you. I've been following you 4 days, calling and calling. Didn't you hear me?
Not just till now. You look winded.
I sure am. I can hardly catch my breath.
Come here, sit down. Take a rest. Oh. He's a friend of mine. Well, buddy, I want you to meet my friend, Mr. Ward.
How do you do, Mr. Ward?
Hello.
Well, do you mind if she sits here a while?
Yeah, go on. I don't mind.
I was taking a rest myself, you know, and I took my shoes off on account of my feet being tired.
Yeah, I'm kind of tired too. Isn't it pretty here, though?
Yeah. Is it that?
What do they call this place?
Some kind of fields. He was telling me just a minute ago, though, but I forgot. Hold on. Hey, buddy! Hey, buddy! He's dead to the world. He's thinking again.
What's the matter with him?
He's the guy who killed his mother, remember?
Oh, is that him?
Yeah, and he figured out how they were going to roast him at something. And now he found out that they're going to do nothing to him, and it's kind of cut his goat.
Poor fellow.
Yeah, it kind of takes it hard.
He looks like a nice young fellow.
Well, you're pretty good for sore eyes. I never expected to see you here.
Oh, I thought maybe you'd be kind of surprised.
Well, surprise is right. But when did you die?
Right after you did. A couple of days ago.
What happened? Got hit by a truck or something?
No. I blew out the gas.
Oh, come on. What was the big idea?
I don't know. I lost my job.
Well, I bet you're sorry you did it, ma'am.
No, I'm not sorry. Not a bit. Mr. Zero, I've been thinking.
What?
I've been thinking it would be kind of nice if you and me, if we could kind of talk things over.
Sure. What do you want to talk about?
I don't know, but we haven't ever really talked things over, have we?
Yeah, you're right. We haven't. Well, let's go to it.
Well, I thought it would be nice if we could be alone. See?
Oh, yeah. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy.
Were you speaking to me?
Oh, yes. How'd you guess it? I thought maybe you'd like to walk around a little and look for your mother.
No, it's no use. I've looked everywhere.
Well, maybe over there they might know.
No, Mr. Zero. She's not here.
All right. My friend and I, see, we used to work in the same store. And we got some things to talk over, you know, business kind of confidential things. So if it's not too much of asking.
Of course, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Excuse me, miss.
He's a good guy at that.
It sure is pretty here, isn't it?
Yeah, sure is.
Look at the flowers. Aren't they just perfect? You would think they were artificial or something.
Yeah, but you would.
And the smell of them, like perfume?
Yeah.
I'm crazy about the country, aren't you?
Well, it's quite nice for a change.
Those store picnics, remember?
Yeah, they sure were fun.
One time. I guess you don't remember. Me and you? We sat under the tree just like we're doing now?
I sure remember.
Go on, I'll bet you don't.
Well, I'll bet I do. It was the year the wife didn't come.
Yeah, I didn't think you'd remember.
And coming home together, we sat in the truck.
Yeah, there's something I always wanted to ask you.
And why didn't you?
I don't know. I guess it didn't seem refined. But I'm going to ask you anyhow.
Yeah, go ahead.
Well, while we were coming home, you put your arm up on the bench behind me, and I could kind of feel your knee pressing against mine.
Yeah, what about that?
Well, what I wanted to ask you was it kind of accidental?
Accidental? Well, sure was accidental. Accidental on purpose.
Do you mean it?
You mean you didn't know?
No, I always wanted to ask you.
Then why did you get sore at me?
Sore? When was I sore? I wasn't sore.
That night, you sure were sore. If you weren't sore, why did you move away?
Just to see if you meant it. I mean, if you meant it, you would move up closer. And when you took your arm away, I knew you didn't mean it.
And all the time I thought you were sore at me. That's why I took my arm away. You know, if I moved up closer, you'd scream. And then I'd be in a jam, like reading the paper about guys getting pulled in for annoying women.
And I was wishing if you could put your arm around me, just wishing all the way home.
Had I only known, but I didn't think you cared about me.
I never cared anything about anybody else but you.
Do you mean it? Really? You're not kidding me, are you?
I mean it. I'm not kidding. I'm telling you the truth. I often thought of saying it before, but I never had the nerve. I mean it. Every word of it.
And me yelling at you for reading too fast and reading too slow?
Yeah. Why did you do it?
I don't know. I swear I don't. And, you know, while I'd be getting those numbers, I was thinking how the wife would die and you and me could get married.
I used to think of that too.
And before even I knew it, I was yelling at
you. Those were the times I thought of blowing up the gas, but I never did till you were gone. And as I was doing it, I was thinking about you and hoping that maybe I'll meet you again. And I made up my mind, if I ever did, I would tell you.
Well, I'm glad you did. I sure am glad you did. But it doesn't do much good now, does it?
No, I guess it doesn't. But there's something else I want to tell you.
What?
I want you to kiss me.
You bet I will.
Not like that. I don't mean like that. I mean really kiss me. On the mouth. So that's what it's like. I never thought anything could be like that.
Well, I've never seen you looking that pretty before. With your cheeks all red and your eyes shining. I've never seen your eyes shining like that.
Do you hear? Do you hear the music?
No.
Yeah, listen, you hear it.
Yeah! Yeah, I hear it!
Is it beautiful?
It's wonderful!
And I seem to find the happiness I see. When we're out together, dancing cheek to cheek. Yes, heaven.
Hey, I'm in
heaven.
That isn't a bad idea.
I began to come around me.
Just imagine if we could stay here all the time.
Yeah, I wish we could. But this place is only for the good ones.
Well, we aren't so bad, are we?
Oh, come on. Me a murderer, and you committing suicide? And anyway, they wouldn't stand for us here.
I don't see why.
You don't? You know, that's not right. Haven't I got a wife?
Not anymore, you don't. When you're dead, that ends it. Don't they always say, until death do us apart?
Well, you're right, but still, they wouldn't stand for us here.
It would be great. We could make up for all those years.
Yeah, I wish we could. I'm crazy about you. I've never seen you looking that pretty before, with your cheeks all red, and your eyes shining, and your hair hanging down. Oh, you got beautiful hair.
We got each other now, don't we?
Yeah. Yeah, and I'm crazy about you, Daisy. Daisy? That's such a pretty name. It's a flower, isn't it? That's what you are. Just like a flower.
We can always be together, can't we?
As long as they let us. I'm crazy about you, Daisy. What's that?
What's the matter?
Oh, he's coming back.
What if he does?
Well, he's an awful moral guy. You don't want him to see us lying around like that, do you?
I don't care if he does.
Well, you should care. You don't want people talking about us.
I don't care if they do.
Well, you better pull down your skirt and fix your hair. Well, you came back all right, didn't you?
Yeah. I hope I haven't returned too soon.
Nah, we were just having a little talk, you know?
We were wishing we could stay here all the time.
You may if you like.
What?
Yes. Anyone who likes may remain.
But I thought you were telling me...
Just as I told you. Only the most favored remain. But anyone may.
I don't get it. There's a catch in it somewhere.
It doesn't matter as long as we can stay.
We were thinking about getting married.
You may or may not. They don't care.
What? You mean to say there are some here who are not married?
Yeah.
I don't know about this place at all. It must be kind of a mixed crowd.
It doesn't matter as long as we got each other.
Yeah, but you don't want to mix with people who are not respectable, do you?
Can't we get married right away? I guess there are a lot of ministers here somewhere, aren't there?
Well, not as many as I had hoped to find. The two who seem most beloved are Dean Swift and Aberable, and they are much admired for some indecent tales which they have written.
What? Ministers writing smutty stories? What kind of a dump is this anyway?
I don't know, Mr. Zero. I don't know. The people here are so strange. They're so unlike the good people I know. They seem to think of nothing but enjoyment, or of wasting their times in profitless occupations. Some paint pictures from morning until night, or carve blocks of stones. Others write songs, or put words together day in and day out. Still others do nothing but lie under the trees and look at the sky. There are men who spend all their time reading books, and women who think only of writing articles, and they are forever telling stories and laughing and singing and drinking and dancing. They are drunkards, thieves, vagabonds, academicians, non-believers, and all that. Enough! Enough! I heard enough!
What are you going to do?
I'm going to leave. That's what I'm going to do.
Well, I thought you liked it here.
Liked it? You don't mean to say you want to stay here with all these hippies and hobos, do you?
We don't have to bother with them. We can just sit under the tree, look at the flowers, and listen to the music.
Music? Did you hear music?
Yeah, don't you hear it?
No. They say it never stops, but I never heard it.
I thought I heard it before, but now I don't hear anything. Well, what's the quickest way out of this place anyway?
But can't you just stay here a little longer?
Well, didn't you hear me say I'm gone? Goodbye, Mr. Ward.
I will never see him again.
Are you going to stay here?
It doesn't matter. Without him, I might as well be alive.
I said stop punching that damn machine.
Stop.
Yeah, you can stop, can't you? Yeah, Joe, give me a hand. This fella here seems to not be able to stop.
Why can't you guys just leave me alone? What's the big idea?
How long you been here anyway?
Just 25 years.
Well, 300 months and 91,031,000.
Yeah.
I've never missed a day. Not an hour, not a minute. But look at all I've got done.
Well, it's time to quit.
Quit? What do you mean, quit? I'm not going to quit.
Well, you've got to wait, tell you.
What for? What do I have to quit for?
It's time for you to go back.
Go back where?
What are you talking about?
Back to the earth, you fool.
What do you think?
What's this you're trying to tell me about going back?
Exactly as I'm saying. Now, you must be pretty thick. How many times do you need to be told the same damn thing?
This is the first time I heard about going back.
No, you didn't think you were going to stay here forever, did you?
Sure. Why not? I've got my bit, didn't I? 45 years of it. 25 years in the store. And then the boss fired me and I knocked him cold. I guess you haven't heard about that.
Yeah, I've heard all about that. What does that have to do with anything?
Well, I've got my bit, didn't I? That Abba let me out.
So, you thought you were all through, did you?
Sure I do. I did the best I could while I was there. And then I died. Now I'm sitting pretty here.
You know, you've got a pretty fine idea about how the way things has run. Do you think we would go through all the trouble of making a soap just to use it once?
Well, once is often enough, seems to me.
Oh, it seems to you, does it? Well, who the hell are you? And what do you know about anything? We use a soap over and over again. Over and over until it's worn out.
Well, nobody ever told me.
So,
You thought you were all through, didn't you? That's pretty funny, that is.
Well, how was I to know?
Use your brains, you idiot! Where would we put them all? We're crowded enough in here as it is. This place is more of a kind of a repair shop or a service station. We get the souls in here by the bushel full, and we get busy and we clean them up. You should see some of them, though. The muck and the slime. Ooh. And as full of holes as a flower sieve. Well, you know, we disinfect them. Give them a good kerosene rub, we mend the holes, and we push them on through. Practically good as new.
So, you mean I've been here before? Before the last time, I mean?
Been here before? Who are you awful? You've been here thousands of times before. 50,000 times at least.
Well, how is that I don't remember anything?
Well, it's partly because you're an idiot. But it's mostly to do with that's the way they fix it. You see, they're funny that way. Every once in a while, they do something good like that when you least expect it. I guess the economy's at the bottom of it, though. They figure the souls would just get worn out quicker if they remember.
So, don't any of them remember?
Oh, sure, some of them remember. You see, there's different kinds of souls. There's a kind that gets a little bit better each time they go back. We just give them a quick wash and push them on through. But then, there's the other kind. The kind that gets a little worse each time they go back. And that's where you belong.
Me? You mean to say I'm getting worse all the time?
A little worse each time.
Then what was I when I first started? Something big? Like a king or something?
A king! That's a good one, that is. I'll tell you what you were the first time you went back. If you really want to know so bad. You was a monkey.
A monkey?
Yes, sir. Just a long-tailed, chattering little monkey.
Well, that must have been a long time ago, though.
And a million years or so. Seems like just yesterday to me.
Well, then look here. What do you mean by saying I'm getting worse all the time?
Exactly as I'm saying.
You know, you were so bad as a monkey.
Of course, you did what all the other monkeys did, but get you out in the open air, which was something. And you weren't woman shy, I'll tell you that much. There was this one little red-headed monkey. Ah, never mind, forget about that. But you weren't so bad, you know. But even in those days, there was some bigger, brainier monkey which you obeyed to. Yes, sir, the mark of the slave was on you from the start.
You're not very particular about what you call people, are you?
You wanted to know the truth, didn't you? And if there was ever a soul that was labeled slave in the world, it was yours. All the bosses and kings that ever were left the trademark on your backside.
It's not fair, if you ask me.
Don't tell me about it. All I know is you've been getting worse and worse each time you've gone back. Even 6,000 years ago, you weren't so bad. That's when you were hauling them big stones for those things they call pyramids in a place they call Africa. You ever hear the pyramids?
Yeah, those big pointed things, right?
Those are the things.
Yeah, I've seen a picture of them in your movies.
Well, you helped build them. It was a long step down from the happy days of the jungle. But it was a good job. Even though you didn't know what you were doing and your back was striped by the foreman's whip. And you've been going down and down ever since. 2,000 years ago, you were a Roman galley slave. Again with the whip. But you had muscles then. Chest muscles. Back muscles. Biceps. Look at you now. Bunch of mush. Hey! Wake up, you mutt! Where do you think you are? And then another 1,000 years you were a serf, a lump of clay digging up other lumps of clay. You were an iron collar then, because the white ones hadn't been invented yet. Another long step down, but where you dug potatoes grew and that'll fatten the pigs, which was something. And now, I don't want to rub it in.
Both Robin is right.
Seems to me I had a pretty healthy kick coming. But
I haven't had a square deal. Hard work, that's all I've got.
Well, what else was you ever good for?
That's not the point. The point is, I'm done. I'm through. Let them find somebody else to do the dirty work. I'm sick of being a goat. I quit right here and now.
What was that?
Calm down, man. Isn't that gonna hurt you? It's just a way of telling you that they don't like what you're saying.
Come on, man, get a hold of yourself. There's nothing you can do about it. It's a lousy system, but they've got it all fixed. There's nothing you can do.
Oh, why can't they stop picking on me? I'm satisfied here. Do my day's work. I don't want to go back.
You've got to, I tell you. There's no way out.
Who will give me a job? What chance have I got at my age?
You didn't think you were going back the way you are, did you?
Sure.
How then?
No, you gotta do it all over again.
All over?
Yeah. You're gonna be a baby again. A boy,
little red-faced animal. And you're gonna do it all over again. And there's gonna be millions of others just like you. All the little mouths open and squalling for food. And then when you grow up, you're gonna learn things. You're gonna learn all the wrong things, and you're gonna learn them in all the wrong ways. You're gonna eat the wrong foods, you're gonna wear the wrong clothes, and you're gonna live in swarming dens where there's no light and there's no air. You're gonna learn to be a coward, a bully, a braggart, a thief, a liar, a sneak. You're gonna learn to fear the sunlight and hate the beauty. And by that time, you'll be ready to go to school. And when you get there, they're gonna tell you the truth about a great many things that you don't give a damn about. And they're gonna tell you lies about all the things that you should know. And the things that you wanna know about, they won't tell you a thing at all about them. And by that time, my friend, you'll be equipped for a life of work. You'll be ready to take a job.
So what will my job be? Another adding machine?
Oh, sure, another adding machine. But not this old antiquated adding machine, no. It'll be a superb, super, hyper adding machine. As far away from this piece of junk as you are from God. It'll be something to make you sit up and take notice, that adding machine. It'll have a big screen on it in front of which you'll sit all day in your tiny little cubicle, adding up numbers and writing reports. It's gonna link you to the rest of your colleagues, to the rest of the world. Say, that'll be some machine, won't it? Some machine is right. It'll be the final triumph of the evolutionary process, the culmination of all human effort. For millions of years, nebulous gases, they swirled around in space. And for more millions of years, those gases, they cooled. And through inconceivable ages, they hardened into rock. And then, life! Tiny little green things all over the water, all over the earth. In more millions of years, and a step upward, an animate organism in an ancient slime. And so on, down through the ages. Again here, again there. The mollusk, the fish, reptile, mammal, man! And also, at some day, you might sit in your tiny little cubicle and operate your super hyper adding machine.
Well, then, I'm not so bad after all. You're a failure, Zero! A failure! A waste product! A slave to the contraption of steel and iron! The animal's instinct, but not his strength and his skill. The animal's appetite, but not as unchained indulgence of them. Sure, you move and you eat and you digest and excrete and reproduce. But any microscopic organism can do as much. Well, guess what? Time's up. Back you go. Back to your sunless grove. The raw material of slums and wars. The ready prey of the first politician who took trouble to play upon your ignorance and provincialism and credulity. You poor, spineless, brainless fool. Well, I'm sorry for you.
Then keep me here. Don't send me back.
Didn't I tell you there's nothing I can do for you? Come on, man, let's go.
No, I can't. I can't. I'm afraid to go through it all again.
Well, you've got to. I tell you, there's no way out of it.
Then why did you tell me so much for? Couldn't you just let me go thinking everything was going to be all right?
All right, I'll see what I can do for you. I'll send you a girl to keep you company.
A girl? What good will a girl do me?
Oh, she'll help make you forget.
She will?
Yeah.
Where is she?
Oh, well, where is she? Give me a minute. I'll call to her.
Oh, Hope! You who?
Yes!
Yeah, why don't you come over here for a minute? There's a fellow here who wants you to go back.
All right! I'll be right over, Charlie, dear.
Charlie, dear.
Kind of familiar, isn't she?
What did you say her name was?
Oh, it's Hope.
H-O-P-E.
Oh, man, is she good looking?
Is she good looking? I'll tell you what. She's got this beautiful blonde hair and these big, beautiful blue eyes.
Well, that sounds good to me. But will she be long, though?
Oh, no, she won't be long. Actually, there she is over there. You see her?
Where?
Over in the corridor. Not over there, a little bit to the right. You see that blonde hair of hers and the sun shining in her face?
Yeah. Yeah, I see her. Well, what's the matter with me anyhow?
Yeah, sure. Well, I'll make you forget your troubles.
Wow, she is hot. What troubles are you talking about?
Oh, no, nothing. You go on ahead. Don't keep her waiting.
Well, you bet I won't.
Hey! Hey,
Oh, wait a minute. Hey, I'll be there in a minute. Hello.
What in the hell is the matter with you?
Did you get it? He thinks he's so good and he's following you.
You shut your face.
What's the idea? Can't even laugh when I see something funny?
You shut your face or I'll show you something that's funny. Now go on, get out of here. And give me something to clean this mess up. There's another fella moving in here. I'll tell the world. This is a lousy job.
Thank you.
Sure I killed him. I'm not saying I didn't. Sure I killed him. Damn lawyers. They give me a good stiff pain, that's what they give me. Half the time I don't even know what the hell they are talking about. Objection sustained, objection overruled. What's the big idea anyhow? You haven't heard me do any objecting, have you? No? What's the idea of objecting? You've got a right to know. What I say is, if a guy kills another guy, you've got a right to call him for it. That's what I say. I know all about that. I've been on the jury too. Damn lawyers. All that bull about being red ink on the bill file. Red ink? It was blood. I want you to get that right. I killed him right through the heart with the bill file. I want you to get that right. All of you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 12 of you, 6 and 6. 6 and 6, that makes 12, and 3 more 15, 5 more 20, and 8 more 28, and 8 and carry 2, and goddamn numbers, I can't forget them. 25 years, 8 hours a day, except Sundays. July and August, half day Saturday. 1 week's vacation with pay and another week without pay if you want it. But who the hell wants it? Laying around the house listening to the wife complaining? Oh, and legal holidays, I nearly forgot them. Washington's birthday, New Year, Decoration Day, Election Day, Labor Day, Thanksgiving, Christmas. And if you're a Jew, Yom Kippur. And the other one, I forgot what they call it. Damn kikes, always getting two when the other guys get one. So, if a holiday comes on Sunday, you get Monday off, so that's fair enough. But when the 4th of July comes on Saturday, why, you're out of luck on account of Saturdays being half day anyway. 25 years, and I never missed a day. And I was never more than 5 minutes late. Look at my time card if you don't believe me. 8:27, 8:28. 8:29, 8:30, 8:31, 8:32, 8:32 makes 40 and goddamn numbers. I can't forget them. Sure, I killed him. But why didn't he shut up? If he had only shut up, instead of talking about how sorry he was and what a good guy I was and this and that, I felt like saying to him, for Christ's sake, shut up! But I didn't have the nerve. I didn't have the nerve to say that to the boss. And when he went talking about how sorry he was standing right close to me, and there was this bill file where I could reach it. I shouldn't have killed him. I know. When I read about him and his three kids in the papers, I felt awful. Really. They had the kid's picture right next to mine. And the paper said the store would be closed for 3 days on account of the boss being dead. That handed me a laugh. All those employees having me to thank for getting 3 days off. I shouldn't have killed him. I know that. But I thought he was giving me a raise on account of being there for 25 years. He never talked to me before, and when I saw him coming up to my desk, I felt like choking. I shouldn't have done that. Killing someone, that's wrong. There was this girl, Judy Allure. 6 months they gave her. It was a dirty trick telling the cops on her, but what was I supposed to do? The wife wouldn't shut up about it. I had to do it. She used to walk around the room just in her underwear. Nothing else on. Just her underwear. They gave her 6 months, and perhaps that's the last I'll ever see of her. Man, shoe salesmen are really lucky. Looking at women's legs all day. Damn lawyers, saying the same thing over and over again. I never said I didn't kill him. But that isn't the same as being a regular murderer. Do I look like a murderer? Do I? I never harmed anybody. Ask the wife, she'll tell you. Ask anybody. I never got into trouble. Well, you wouldn't count that time at the baseball game. That was just for fun. I'm a pretty steady guy. You gotta admit that. 25 years in one job and I never missed a day. 52 weeks in a year. 52 and 52. They didn't have to look for me, did they? I didn't try to run away, did I? Where was I going to run to? And I wasn't thinking about that at all. I'll tell you what I was thinking about. How I was going to tell the wife about being fired.
25 years in the same job and never missed a day. 25 years and nothing to show for it.
He fired me after 25 years. Did the lawyers tell you about that? Objection sustained, objection overruled, answer yes or no. It just gives me a headache and I can't get those damn numbers out of my head. But he kept on talking and talking, and there was this bill file where I could reach it. I'm just a regular guy, like anybody else, like you guys. Suppose you were me. Maybe you would have done the same thing. That's the way you ought to look at it. Suppose you were me. No, wait a minute, you don't understand. Just give me another chance and I'll tell you how it was. I'm all mixed up on account of those damn lawyers and I can't get those damn numbers out of my head. But just give me another chance and I'll tell you how it was. He fired me after 25 years. I was there for 25 years. And he fired me after 25 years. 25 years.